Welcome aboard the System 76 transmission log. Our broadcast is about to begin. This is the latest on System 76 computers, manufacturing, and Pop! OS. Now, for your in-orbit crew.
Emma, what is your favorite kind of chocolate?
Dark chocolate.
That is the correct answer.
Yes, 86% is what I prefer.
I'm eating 88 right now, actually. Not right now, otherwise you'd hear me biting on some squares. But
I heard you biting on squares earlier.
That you did. So, perks of working at System 76.
Yes, chocolate all the time. All right, let's get started. I'm Emma.
I'm Alex.
And this is System 76 Transmission Log.
Welcome.
Let's get into the news.
All right. Well, first up, we got a new darter just hit the market. It's our screen real estate laptop, 14 or 16 inch ultra portable 1610 display. It's got that nice silver finish, and it's just been upgraded with the Core Ultra 200 series CPUs from Intel.
But it has not updated the chassis, so still rocking that same silver slick chassis that we love so much. And looking as pro as can be.
Absolutely. That darter. Real stalwart in the office.
Let's move on to the next topic. The launch keyboards. Still on sale.
Still on sale, folks. They are $40 to $60 off, depending on which one you get. Manufactured right here in Denver.
Alex, what's your favorite Switch type?
Favorite Switch type. Well, I was going to say Nintendo, but I feel like dropping a company wouldn't really be good here, so I'm just gonna say
you're so funny. You're just so clever today.
I use the Jades on mine currently. I have a pre-production model because I had to write about how the keys felt on the website. Enjoyed it a lot, and I started with the Royals, but the clacky sound is a little weird to me. And then I tried the clicky ones, and it was a lot more satisfying on my fingertips. And then we introduced the Browns, so I do want to give those a shot. I think I would like them a lot. But for now, I have to say the Jades, because I haven't tried the Browns.
Can you guess what my favorite Switch type is?
Is it the Pinks?
It is. Good guess. What's next? Kubecon. We are done with Kubecon Europe, and that was a big one. Thelio Astra making its rounds again all over the world, it seems. She was on display doing a demo at the Splunk booth and the ARM booth. At the ARM booth, it was showing off all 128 cores running LLMs using Bluefin and Rama Llama, which is really interesting and visually fun to watch with BTOP going at the same time. And yeah, we don't know where Astra is off to next, but we're going to share it, so get excited.
It's like the Carmen Sandiego of computers this year.
It is, yes. Like, everybody wants to show off Astra. Yeah, KubeCon's over, but LinuxFest Northwest is up next, and we won't be bringing an Astra out there, but we will be bringing some Meerkats and Pangolins and launch keyboards. And Carl will be doing a talk on COSMIC DE and the progress from the last year.
Yeah, partly because he introduced COSMIC at LinuxFest Northwest the last time he was there. People have been waiting for the sequel, and this is now the sequel, and believe it or not, it will be better than the original.
Yes, we are excited to watch. And we're also hosting a lunch the Saturday of the fest, so come by and see us and grab a sandwich and say hi.
BYO BBQ, right?
No barbecue, actually. I definitely want to bring barbecue sauce.
So it is bring your own barbecue sauce.
No, it is. I just said it wasn't. So no, why would you say it is?
Well, because if the barbecue wasn't happening, then you'd need to bring your own sauce.
Well, what's up next?
COSMIC. People have been wondering where that's at. We are still putting together Alpha 7. There's a few features we want to get together for what we hope is the last alpha release before we switch to beta. So we're working on things like pinned workspaces. People have been asking about static workspaces. That's sort of our solution to that. And then pausing for dramatic effect / thinking. We've got some accessibility features in the works and more.
Well, thanks for that update about COSMIC.
Emma, we have a fantastic guest here with us today, as always.
Yes, a longtime friend of System 76.
Michael Dominick. Some of you may know him.
Today we have Mike Dominick from The Mad Botter, an AI development company and a well-known nerd in the Linux community. Welcome, Michael.
Thanks for having me, folks.
Can you tell us what is Mad Botter and what do you do there?
We're, at our core, a small software company based out of Tampa, Florida. We do automation and AI-enabled software, which is just a fancy way to say we automate basically large sets of data for regulated industries. So think the military and military contractors, large construction, folks who have large sets of data locked in legacy systems and need to pull them forward for either compliance issues or just to, you know, not be running everything in Microsoft Access, which you would be surprised how many big companies are relying on one Access database to run a, you know, multi-million-dollar business.
I thought on your website I saw ChatGPT and some of your work. How do you implement that with your app?
We're an OpenAI developer, right? So a ChatGPT developer. Our Alice product has a optional ChatGPT integration that just basically takes some preset prompts, ties it into our algorithm to try to understand, you know, we don't want to be too mean to some of these legacy systems, but shall we say more obscure data formats? I don't know if anybody's old enough to remember Fox Pro databases here, but we get kind of a lot of those.
What are you most excited about with the future of AI?
You know, I think it's going to level the playing field for, frankly, younger folks. I have an 8-year-old, soon to be 9, and with just a little bit of help in like Cursor, he's able to fully develop Minecraft, little Minecraft mods, doing a lot with Pygame. And I think that would have been far more challenging for him and obviously kids his age without just that, you know, little bit of extra hand.
Does your son use like ChatGPT to help with his coding?
Yeah, via the Cursor IDE, which is a offshoot of VS Code.
Okay, cool.
So is there a reason for the Alice in Wonderland theme? How does that tie into the company?
Well, anybody who listens to Coder Radio knows that I'm a little eccentric. So I'd like to tell you there was a really good, smart, you know, Forbes 500 business reason for that. I thought it was cool, the idea of reinterpreting Lewis Carroll's, you know, Alice in Wonderland universe to basically be, if you want to look at the website, 1950s retro robots, right?
Yeah, I like it. It's so cool. And the little pet rabbit is fun, too.
Yep. We used to have a product actually called the Rabot, which that little pet rabbit is.
Yeah, Rabot. That's clever. What's your Linux background?
Oh, so we could go all the way back in time. I started with Linux on the desktop when the only color choice was brown. At least that's what Ubuntu told me at the time. So I want to say, is that 8.10 or 9.10, somewhere in there? Spent a lot of tears trying to set up Ubuntu TV. Just so much pain. Eventually, I actually am a POP user now. And on my kick around machine, which is also a System76, used COSMIC. I'm actually on the latest alpha. I think we just is going to update to beta, but I don't know when that is. I might have already done it because I know it's a rolling release. So yeah, it's been using it on the desktop for a long time. I love my Thelio. I tend to buy more Thelios than I actually use because I give them away once a year to middle school and high school students.
That's fun. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so every year we do an Earth Day competition. You could be, just have to be in the U.S., high school or middle school, actually, and do some sort of coding or engineering. It doesn't have to be coding. One year, a kid actually brought in he actually designed something in OpenCAD, which was really cool, like his own take on a hydroponic fish tank, where on top of the tank was, you could grow your hydroponic. His example was strawberries, but you know, it could be anything, right?
Super cool.
Yeah, these kids come up with amazing stuff, Emma. It's really... You know, there's no cost to entry. There's no gimmick. We don't charge for anything. Every year we pick one winner. That winner gets a brandy new Thelio. You guys have been kind enough to allow me to buy them and ship them directly for me, so I don't have to deal with that. I think it's obviously very small impact, but it's good to see enthusiasm in young people for this stuff, especially when, I don't know if you've ever heard of Fortnite, but they sure spend a lot of time on Fortnite.
I think Roblox is the new one, too.
I know. See, I'm dating myself
already. It's not even that new.
Even when I'm trying to say get off my lawn, I am just so old, I don't even know where the lawn is now. But yeah, my kid loves Roblox. He loves that and Minecraft. And weirdly, Scratch, which runs great on Linux. So that's a nice plus, because I'm forcing him actually to use my old Pangolin.
You're talking about your System76 machines. Can you tell us what machines you've used and what are some of your favorites? Or what is your favorite?
Okay, I'm going to try to not butcher any model names here. The first, I think it was the first Ultrabook you guys did. I was actually in Denver when you were showing it off, the Galago Pro. I have the Lemur. I have, I think, the new Pangolin. that I just got. I actually have a customer who every time they want to send me data that they don't want shared on other machines, they buy one of your laptops and send it to me. So
that's interesting.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy. I have an Onyx. I know it's not a pure System76 machine, but I'm sure you guys remember the HP Dev 1 collaboration you guys did.
Mm-hmm.
That's actually
that was an exciting one around the office.
Yeah, that's my road machine, actually, because of the portable size. I just throw it in my bag, and if I have to, let's say I tend to have to fly to New York or, you know, North Carolina, it's a perfect machine for that. But the workhorse, like doing the heavy lifting, any kind of real computation, is still my trusty Thelio.
Awesome. So I think you've had it since the first Thelio. So you've had it for like 6-7 years?
Yep. I actually have 2 Thelios. Yep. But I have both of them. The old Thelio is also still in service, doing some just like internal company server stuff.
Have you upgraded it?
I upgraded the RAM in it, and I wildly upgraded the storage just to meet the new needs of the server. But then I got greedy and bought another one that was a Threadripper, and that's what's doing all the... So this might be too inside baseball. I'm trying to run some of these MLs locally just for, obviously, data privacy for folks, but also these APIs are going to get expensive, and it's not a bad idea to try to... I don't know. This is where my old man shaking his fist at the clouds again. I truly believe you should host your own content, right? You should try to host your own blog instead of using something like Medium. You should maybe not pump all your data up to ChatGPT. So that's where running some of these LMs has been an interesting experiment. It's gone fairly well. I don't know. It just seems like a great horizon for the open source community and Linux in particular. I can't go too much into it, but I've been doing some kind of generation and training 3D graphics files. And I just started playing around with, I'm going to get the libraries wrong, so I won't try, with it on a fancy Mac and the newer Thelio. And the Thelio blew it out simply because, in my opinion, the software is now being primarily written for a Linux environment in terms of performance, right, to do the computations. And the advantage, it's unbelievable. And to pay a service to do this for us would be, frankly, a significant bill.
All right. So we've gone through what System76 products you've used.
Oh, I didn't mention my favorite.
Oh, right.
So this is a little oddball. I have the original launch keyboard right here. I don't know if you can hear the clacking. You will pry it from my cold, dead hands. I love this thing.
So you've got the Jade switches then.
Yep.
You said clacking.
Oh, they're clacking.
That's awesome. So do you have a certain color scheme that you do, or do you just go full rainbow?
I was doing the rainbow beach ball thing.
Mm-hmm.
I ended up finding it distracting, so now I just do it where the meteor shower when you type.
Cool.
Anybody who doesn't have a launch will think I sound crazy. There's a utility application that you can change. They all have names, right? One is called Galaxy, one's called Meteor Strike.
We've talked a lot about the System76 machines you have, and it seems to go back a long way. How did you first find us?
That's a great question, because I don't think I remember the answer. It was a long time ago. We're talking a long time ago. How did I first find you? You know how I found you? I know exactly how I found you. It was Chris Fisher when I would, you know, because we used to do Coder Radio together, and I think he had you on one of the other JB shows. Not you personally. I think it was Carl.
Yeah, and it was at the Linux Action Show, wasn't it?
It was a long time ago.
It was the one with video too, right?
Yeah, it was the old, right, when they used to have like the anchor desk and everything. I think
The background was like the webpage that they were talking about,
yep,
or whatever.
Yep.
That was so ahead of everybody else's time.
They're doing such awesome stuff over there. He was so, the idea of a podcast network, you think about it now, there's tons of them, right? The New York Times, all these big shots have them. But Chris really and the whole team at JB kind of pioneered what an independent podcast network could look like.
Yeah, this was like 13 years ago.
Yeah, because he and I started Coder together, it was 13 years ago.
So cool to see how the community has stuck together and stuck with their projects and how everyone is still knowing each other and communicating and staying in touch.
I remember a lot of us used to like not have kids before this started, right?
Yep. Is there anything you'd like to tell the community about the MadBot?
If you need any kind of ETL data processing or automation done, and you want a local US-based vendor, we are here for you. We do use exclusively open source tools. So when you go with us, you're not going to be forced to like buy a license to, I probably shouldn't name names, but large, expensive enterprise data processing tools that will lock you in forever.
And how can people get in touch with you?
You can either go to alice.dev, you could go to themadbotter.com, or just email me, mike@themadbotter.com.
Awesome. Well, we appreciate you coming on the show today. We are so excited to share your experience with the community, and hope you have all the best success with the Madbotter.
Thank you so much. Been a pleasure.
Looks like we've covered all our bases.
3, 2, 1, 0.
This has been the System76 Transmission Log. For more inspiration, check out the website and follow us on social media. On your descent back to Earth, please keep your hands and feet inside the transport beam at all times. Captain Sinoff, in transmission.